Detained Nobel laureate Aung San Suu Kyi given a 6-year jail term by a Myanmar junta court. She was found guilty in 4 cases of corruption. The 77-year-old pro-democracy leader has already been sentenced to 11 years in jail for corruption, incitement against the military, and breaking a telecommunications law. Suu Kyi's lawyers have been banned from speaking to the media. She has been detained since Myanmar generals toppled her government in a coup on February 1st last year. The U.S. describes the latest sentence handed to Suu Kyi as an affront to justice and the rule of law. In news overseas, China conducts fresh military drills around Taiwan. That's as another U.S. congressional delegation visits the island. Beijing slammed the visit, calling it a continued violation of the One China policy. It also accused Washington of again undermining peace and stability across the Taiwan Strait. The 5-member U.S. delegation is being led by Democratic Senator Ed Markey. According to Washington's de facto embassy in Taipei, the visit will focus on trade, regional security, and climate change. The unannounced 2-day trip came after Beijing sent warships, missiles, and jets into the waters and skies around Taiwan in response to U.S. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi's visit earlier this month.
A national holiday in Afghanistan as the Taliban mark the first anniversary of their return to power. The hardline Islamists captured Kabul on August 15, 2021, ending 20 years of U.S.-led military intervention. The takeover followed days of chaos as tens of thousands of people rushed to the Kabul airport, hoping to get out of the country. The Taliban had initially vowed a softer version of their harsh Islamist rule than their first stint in power back in 1996 to 2001, but that has failed to materialize. According to the United Nations, Afghanistan is becoming the world's largest humanitarian crisis, with more than half of its 38 million people facing extreme poverty and hunger. The rights of women have also been stifled as they are barred from going to secondary school and from holding government jobs. Despite repeated calls from the international community to improve the situation, the Taliban have failed to deliver.
Lawyers of WikiLeaks founder Julian Assange have sued the U.S. Central Intelligence Agency and its former director, Mike Pompeo, for alleged spying. The attorneys, along with 2 journalists, say the CIA worked with a security firm contracted by the Ecuadorian embassy in London, where Assange was living at that time, to spy on the WikiLeaks founder, his lawyers, and the others he met with. They assert the alleged spying means Assange's right to a fair trial has now been tainted, if not destroyed.
The recording of meetings with friends, with lawyers, the copying of his attorneys and friends' digital information taints the criminal prosecution because now the government knows the contents of those communications. And there should be sanctions, even up to dismissal of those charges or withdrawal of an extradition request to in response to these blatantly unconstitutional activities.
Assange is facing extradition from Britain to the U.S. He is charged with violating the U.S. Espionage Act for publishing U.S. military and diplomatic files in 2010 related to the Afghanistan and Iraq wars. The Philippines is considering the purchase of U.S. military helicopters after scrapping its chopper deal with Russia. Philippine Ambassador to the U.S. Jose Manuel Romualdez says Manila wants to acquire heavy-lift Chinook helicopters for military operations and disaster preparedness efforts. Ambassador Romualdez says Washington is willing to strike a deal for the same amount that Manila planned to spend on the Russian helicopters. The Russian deal was called off by President Rodrigo Duterte before his term ended in June due to potential sanctions by the U.S. The Philippines had made an initial payment of 2 billion pesos to Russia back in January. It's not clear yet if it can get the money back.
It was very made clear from the very beginning, especially during the Ukraine situation, that the United States and the other Western allies are putting a lot of sanctions against Russia. If you buy anything from Russia, you will be sanctioned. It's really a practical thing for us to simply just to cancel that contract. It's cheaper for us in the end, as they say. So I think it was really prudent, especially for President Duterte, to approve the cancellation of that contract, because it will save us a lot of trouble in the end.